Welcome to the subcommittee of the Health and Human Services Committee. We have one bill on our agenda today, House Bill 520. It's for a hearing only. We're not voting on this bill today. Let me just remind you, we're going to limit individuals to 2 minutes just because we've got a long list of people signed up and we may not get to everybody today. And we'll get started. Okay, Hank Sullivan.
First of all, thank you for the opportunity. Second of all, came all the way down here from coming for 120 seconds of airtime, which I think is really unfair. I'd like for everyone who is against this bill to please stand up. The most egregious part of this bill that I find is the fact that the lead sponsor for the bill owns a company who stands to benefit from its passing. That is because he owns a monitoring company that does monitoring that is described in the bill. He had the same monitoring described in 1013 last year, and thankfully, for the hard work of the Senate, that monitoring aspect was removed. But he stands to gain from this. He and his partners stand to gain from this bill passing, and he's putting funding and he's putting grants in order to fund these different aspects of health.
Madam Chair, I wonder if that would be appropriate for his testimony to be when Chairman Jones is here. Sounds a little bit unfair that he's out
there. Chairman Jones had the opportunity to be here.
Do you have
line numbers in the bill that you're referring to?
Did he should have stayed?
Start his time again.
Yes.
You can
look at line numbers 551 through 558, 545 through 550. You're going to find that these line numbers deal with professional health care program, defining the professional health care program, and the fact that monitoring and rehabilitation of impaired health care professionals for the purpose of this, that, and the other thing. Impaired means the inability of a healthcare professional to practice and reasonable skill and safety to patients by reason of illness or use of alcohol, drugs, narcotics, and chemicals. What he's done is he's defined what his product does, which is a monitoring device. It monitors biometrics as well as GPS. So he's defined in the bill what his particular device actually does that's patented. And he's marketed this to Tennessee. It's in three states right now. It's now in Paulding County and in Fulton County. And I'd like for my entire remarks to go to the committee if I could. All
right. Thank you. Chuck Friedlow.
Thank you, Madam Chair.
Do you want to do